It's almost like a miniature Hollywood production. Sure, it's not quite there yet, but we constantly eat closer and closer to creating some truly impressive cinema. If you're interested in using KlingAI to create things like this, let me give you the rundown. One of the things that immediately struck me about KlingAI is how user-friendly it is. You don't need to be a tech wizard to get started, and the output is consistently high quality. It only typically takes 1 to 3 generations to find something that you really like. I'm talking realistic scenes, smooth animations, pretty much the whole package. As you can see, there are two options to choose from. You can either use text to video or image to video. Both are equally awesome for different reasons. KlingAI's text to video capabilities are surprisingly powerful and generate some of the most realistic scenes I've ever seen. Whether you're brainstorming ideas or just need a quick scene, text to video is a fantastic tool to have in your arsenal. To get started, all you need is to plop a prompt into the prompt window here and click generate. There are a few settings to play with, but if you don't want to adjust anything and just click generate, it's great out of the box. Now let's talk about the creativity versus relevance slider. In theory, it sounds cool, but in practice, it's a bit of a gimmick. My honest advice, keep that slider in the middle. You'll get the best balance of control and creativity. Otherwise, it just seems to add artifacts or morphing to the scenes more times than not. Now, professional mode is where KlingAI truly shines, especially for those jaw-dropping photorealistic scenes. It's perfect for those moments when you want to add that extra layer of polish and realism, especially with complex scenes involving physics or multiple moving elements. But remember, it costs more credits. So my tip, start with the standard mode to test your ideas, then go pro when you're ready to take it to the next level. One other cool feature that is only available in text to video mode is the camera movement. In past videos, I saw a bunch of comments asking about how to get the camera to move in the direction you want it to. That's now possible by clicking camera control and selecting your movement. It even has a slider to adjust direction and intensity. Finally, there's negative prompting, but I rarely used it, so don't feel like you have to add something to every generation. Just keep it simple. Now, image to video is great for creating longer sequences like the video you saw earlier. It has most of the same features that text to video does, but offers more control as you were feeding it an image to animate. You can even add an end frame to create some really cool combinations. The only thing I found that it doesn't do as well as some of the other tools are intense visual effects like magic or fire. I'm guessing the model was trained more on people and animals because it crushes those generations, but in terms of doing some like ethereal VFX effects, I found that Runway or Luma oftentimes do a better job. KlingAI is an incredible tool and I had so much fun testing this. As I said, most of your generations will come out great in just a few tries. Plus, the pricing plan isn't too bad compared to some of the others out there. I'd love to see what you come up with, so feel free to share in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this, please hit the like and subscribe button for me, and I will catch y'all in the next one.